This movie was surprising to me, and it's shocking how many people like it, especially dudes. Today we're going to talk about The Devil Wears Prada. I really enjoyed that movie. It's interesting because I don't know that I like love or care about the fashion industry to any extreme degree. If anything, I feel like it's a necessary evil that I've had to learn to speak the language of just out of sheer survival. The movie is so interesting because we get to watch Miranda Priestly, this tyrannic, you know, high-end fashionista who's like a powerhouse in this industry. And then we watch young little Andy with frumpy, lumpy blue sweater and clumpy, grumpy hair and I don't know, other kind of umpies. Working for Miranda, and you watch these worlds collide. You watch this clash happen of the fashion industry mixes with the layperson, the peasant, right? And Andy is kind of our look into this world, this whole industry. And you watch her attitude versus theirs and her values versus theirs and blah, blah. And that whole scene comes across very vapid and shallow and, you know, materialistic and all about looks and whatever. And they obviously embrace practices and lifestyle choices that are not healthy for the sake of appearances. And so Andy has a commentary and a reaction, and she's basically vocalizing the audience's perspective on navigating this world. But there's an interesting moment where she's still pretty new to the job, right? And she's working for Miranda, and Miranda's in a room with all these designers and whatever they are. And this woman is holding up two different like turquoise belts, and they're one's thinner than the other, different kind of buckles, whatever. And so she's like, oh, it's a hard choice, because she's looking at these different belts. And Andy like is watching this whole thing. She hears that she's like deliberating between these two belts, and she snickers involuntarily. She's like, pfft. And everyone stops and looks at her, because this is a serious, intense moment, right? She's creating right now. And they all look at her, and she's like, and then the boss is like, oh, is something funny? What's so funny? And she's like, oh, everyone's looking at me. Oh God, nothing. Nothing's funny. Those belts look exactly the same to me. And Miranda realizes in this moment, Andy feels morally superior to this whole scenario, this whole scene, because she thinks the fashion industry is beneath her, that all this stuff is shallow and pointless and insignificant. And Miranda basically tells her, she runs her through this whole like industry process of like, you think that you're totally separate from all this. This is irrelevant to you, or you're irrelevant to this, or you're exempt or whatever. But the sweater you're wearing, the thing you just threw on in the dark this morning, you clearly picked out from some kind of clearance rack at a department store or whatever. And then she goes through a history of like certain times when a certain artist or a certain or designer created or whatever, and trickled down from that world into where Andy is ending up dressing like this, where it says she takes herself too seriously to care about what she looks like. And Miranda basically deconstructs her outfit and says like, the people in this room actually picked out your outfit because we understand the value you have for yourself, and it's not very high. Basically is the implication, and Andy's kind of like stabbed in the chest. And you watch her continue to fight and struggle to like, succeed in this world, even though it's so contrary to her values. And throughout the movie, you actually watch her go through a journey of starting to care a little more about what she looks like, and she starts to be more intentional about the outfits that she wears and the way her hair is done, and her hair gets smaller and smaller as the movie progresses, which is supposed to depict a disciplining and a pruning, right? And it's kind of a visual display of like an internal journey that she's going on. And then eventually her counterpart, who's like super stuck up and totally rude to Annie the whole time, notices like, huh. And she doesn't say the commanding, like, disrespectful thing anymore. She kind of holds it back, which is a sign of respect. We watch Andy go on this journey of becoming more shallow, and she goes to the other end of the spectrum where she's kind of lost in the world a little bit and just, like, petty and gossipy and all about the stuff. But there's a point in her journey, and her boyfriend back home who doesn't care about this Andy and doesn't know this Andy is having a problem with her, right? Like, he doesn't have a value for what she's doing. But there's something cool in this journey that I actually really appreciate, and I think that a lot of us as viewers actually are intrigued by and drawn into. Andy starts developing a value for how she appears, the appearance that she's bringing to the table. I had a boss I was working for a while who did a lot of high-end work with like celebrities and VIPs in her world. And she would often talk to me about how you present yourself, your appearance, your physical dress, and all that is actually ministry to the people that you're working with. You're ministering to them by how you present yourself, even in just the clothes that you're wearing, how you walk and how you talk and how you present. And I actually, in that conversation, noticed value. I'm like, I actually do care about that. Interesting. Maybe I should be more intentional and thoughtful about how I'm portraying myself. Perhaps I'll grow a mustache. Anyway, and so in all of that, Andy goes on this journey and actually starts developing a value for how she presents herself. She's not just frumpy and careless about her appearance anymore, which I would say is actually a legitimate external manifestation of an internal self-respect that is healthy and appropriate. So I don't want to get super opinionated and like, you know, standardy on how you're supposed to dress, but I do want to say, in terms of the choices that we make and how we present ourselves physically, that we want to make choices that are coming from a place of value, not coming from a lack of value, not coming from irresponsibility or negligence, but from intentionality, thoughtfulness, and a purposeful yes to what I believe I'm worth and how I'd like to present myself to the world. Not to trick or manipulate anybody, but to bring our best to the table, because we're worth it, regardless of what anybody else thinks. I love that. Super important, big deal. You guys, self-image, self-respect, such a big deal, and it totally manifests and shows up in the way that you dress. So The Devil Wears Prada is a fun, interesting, adventurous journey through the fashion world, that whole industry and the uglies and the pretties and the whatever. But ultimately, there's this beautiful transformation we get to watch Andy go through, where there are beautiful things to pick up and there are heinous things to not touch, and to find yourself in the midst of it. And we watch her be triumphant throughout this process and come out a whole person better for it, which I love. I highly recommend the movie, worth watching. Comment below, let's see what you think. And remember, guys, when you're watching a movie, you're never alone. Like, subscribe, comment, the bell, ding it, click it for, you know, new videos come out every Wednesday.